Hi, my friends. Finally, at long last, I'm going to make tomato jam with these magnificent Husk cherries that I got at Sylvester Manor. And they're a perfect cross between a cherry and a tomato. They're just gorgeous looking. I can't stop taking pictures of them. When my friend offered me this beautiful little husk tomato, is what it was called, that's what made me immediately think I wanted to make a tomato jam. When I came home to review and research what this was exactly I had eaten and been given at the Sylvester farm, they were called husk cherries. That's why the whole video calls this husk cherries. But they were offered to me as husk tomatoes, and that's what made me want to make the tomato jam. I hope you enjoy it. Thank you.
I hope you'll be inspired to cook more and learn how to shop seasonally so that you're spending less money. And you're going to feel great doing it. And you'll then live resourcefully and mindfully. But because I felt the yield was going to be virtually nothing with these little, these little husk cherries, or ground cherries, I'm going to add some pepperdews and their juice, because this is about one of my favorite things. Just love these pepperdews, and I think it's going to be brilliant as a tomato jam. And then I've got here red pepper flakes and some mustard seed. I took all the husks off of the husk cherries. They're dusty, of course, because they grow very low to the ground. I'm washing them off really well with very cold water. They just pinch right out of their little husks. So I cut the husk cherries in half. Some I'm leaving whole, and now I'm just prepping up these the pepperdews. If you don't have a steel for sharpening knives, you should always sharpen your knife. Honestly, the best thing to use is the bottom of a mug, which I'm going to show you. That's the best. And just keep for yourself a good sharp knife. There's very little equipment you need. You'll see, I don't cook with a Cuisinart. I cook very little. And that's what utilitarian cooking is all about, being very simple about the equipment that I use to cook with. Tricks and treats. That's what Recipes for Survival is, tricks and treats. Tricks in the kitchen and treats that you end up making. Oh my God, I love it. Tricks and treats, Recipes for Survival. Oh, and happy Halloween, and it's Day of the Dead, Halloween, and I don't even have a mask on, except I'm not wearing my glasses. In any case, let's get started. I'm starving. I've gotten enough oil just to, with a thin layer in the bottom of this pot, a good sized pinch of salt of the earth, red pepper flakes and mustard seed in here as well, and infusing the oil that way. And I've got this fabulous liquid from the pepper juice. I'm gonna put a drop of that in there. This is gonna be mean, like I'm making dragon's breath here. It's gonna be killer. Drop more olive oil. And then a little bit of that lime. That's how little I'm using. And all of this is gonna go straight in. The pepper juice and garlic. And then I'm going to grate this ginger in there. Just mince and put ginger slices into this. It's no big deal, which I'm going to do right now. And I got to get these tomatoes in. This is cooking a lot faster than I thought. I just put the half ones in now. I'm going to put a little bit more pepper juice.
And this is just gonna cook down. I'm just gonna, I'm adding all the tomatoes now. I got another idea. I'm gonna add some tomato paste to this. This tree definitely has a trick to it because of the heat in it, but it's absolutely fabulous how it came out. But I'm gonna have it on cheese and crackers and some over easy eggs and omelets and some potatoes, and I'm even gonna have it on my pizzas that I'm gonna make next. I'm starving. And thank you for joining me again for Recipes for Survival, where I hope to inspire you to cook more and shop seasonally and spend less money, and you'll feel so much better for it. Here's the finished tomato jam. This is half of the yield that I got. Then I made a lightly scrambled egg, topped that with the tomato jam, toasted baguette with blue cheese on it. I hope you enjoyed this episode and that you'll be inspired to make tomato jam. Thanks very much. See ya.